in the distant past, there was a Brahmin and his wife who couldn't conceive. The wife, fearing that her husband would no longer love her, selected a second wife for him to marry. When the new wife got pregnant, the first wife realized the potential dangers of her decision. The new wife might receive attention and resources that would have gone to her. She devised a plan to prevent this. She brewed poison and poured a few drops into the new wife's soup, causing a miscarriage. When the new wife recovered, she did it again, causing another miscarriage. By the third pregnancy, the new wife caught on. So she attempted to hide her pregnancy from the first wife. Eventually, the first wife found out about the pregnancy and attempted to cause another miscarriage. But because the new wife already had so much poison in her body, the third concoction turned out fatal. With her dying breath, the new wife looked at the first wife and swore vengeance. In a following rebirth, the first wife was born as a hen with many chicks, and the second wife was born as a forest cat. When the forest cat attacked the hen, she killed all the hen's chicks, but left the hen unharmed. The hen, unable to remember past lives, saw this as an unprovoked act of savagery and swore revenge. In a following rebirth, one wife was born as a doe with a newborn calf, and the other wife was born as a cheetah. When the cheetah attacked, she killed the doe's calf, but left the doe unharmed. The doe, unable to remember past lives, saw this as an unprovoked act of savagery and swore revenge. This cycle repeated itself over countless rebirths, and each wife swore vengeance for what they believed to be unprovoked attacks. In the Buddha's lifetime, both women were reborn, one as a Yakkhini, a demon ogress, and the other is a human woman who had recently given birth. The Yakkhini was relentless in her quest to devour the baby in front of its mother. Desperate and afraid, the woman ran through the gates of the temple and threw her baby at the feet of the Buddha, hoping for protection. As an evil spirit, the Yakkhini couldn't enter the temple, but her hunger for revenge kept her stalking from the gate. The Buddha admonished both the woman and the Yakkhini. He explained that they had been repeating this vicious cycle of killing each other's children for countless lives. He taught that hatred would only beget more hatred, and that although acting out of hatred may have a desirable outcome, it also comes with unintended consequences. The only way to eliminate hatred was to realize this reality. The Buddha said that in order to end her karmic bond, the woman must give her child to the Yakkhini voluntarily. Once the child was in her arms, the Yakkhini became overcome with hunger for revenge. But reflecting on the Buddha's teachings, she began to feel compassion and understanding. Tenderly, the Yakkhini handed the child back to the woman. The Yakkhini and the woman parted ways without any trace of hatred for each other. What do you think the moral of this story is?
We hope you enjoyed the video. Click like if you did, and click subscribe if you want to see our uploads.